Happening today, another round of TB testing for students, faculty, and staff at Southport High School. So far, one case of tuberculosis was confirmed there last week. Our TV6 asks, and TV crews were not allowed inside the school during the first round of TB tests yesterday. These pictures were given to us by a Perry Township Schools employee. We're told Tuesday's testing got off to a good start.
We've had a great response from the administration as far as communication to the students and the parents and the planning. That's gone very well. The students have responded. So we began at 2:30 this afternoon, and within the first 30 minutes, we'd already tested 150 individuals, which I think is a good start.
In addition to the test, students can find out more about TB, including the symptoms. Today's testing will be from 8:30 this morning until 11 o'clock. Students under 18 will need to sign a consent form or be accompanied by a parent.
Mark, an RTV6 update this morning on the HIV outbreak sweeping across southeastern Indiana. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention call it one of the worst documented outbreaks of HIV among IV users in the past two decades. The Scott County outbreak, which was first confirmed back in December, is showing no signs of slowing down. State health officials have confirmed 138 and 5 preliminary positive cases. That's up from 136 confirmed and 6 preliminary cases reported last week. Also, we have new numbers on the Scott County Needle Exchange Program. An estimated 6,500 needles have been brought in, and the Scott County Health Department have provided more than 7,000 needles in return.
New this morning, students at Butler will come together to remember the thousands of people killed by the catastrophic earthquake in Nepal. A candlelight vigil will be held at the Purdue University Engineering Fountain. The Nepalese students at the Purdue organization will also be accepting donations to help with earthquake relief. Let's get you caught up now with the latest developments coming out of Nepal. The death toll now is at more than 5,000. More than 100 others were killed in surrounding India and China. The health minister in Nepal says the death toll could hit 10,000 before this is all said and done. 2 days of national mourning for the victims begin today. Through the night, riot police have been working to calm crowds lining up at bus stations in Kathmandu to get free transportation for thousands hoping to get to their hometowns and villages.
A new video into the RBC RTV6 newsroom overnight showing a man's remarkable recovery after he spent 80 hours trapped in the rubble from that massive 7.8 quake. The 28-year-old is in the hospital this morning. He hurt his leg pretty badly, and the man was on the second floor of a building when everything suddenly started to shake and the building just crumbled, trapping him inside. Good to see he is alive and well there. Now, this video shows the man's harrowing rescue. It took an army of workers about 6 hours to free him. You can see the man's head poking out there before all the rubble is lifted off of him. He had to drink his own waste to survive, but he says he never gave up hope that he would be found alive. Good morning, America. We'll take a look at another amazing story of survival coming out of this tragedy in Nepal. Terry Moran is in Kathmandu, and we'll have a live report. He'll also break down all of the relief rolling in to help the struggling survivors. That's up at 7, right after Good Morning Indiana.
Time now for a check of that forecast. And still a chilly morning out there, but we are hearing the temperatures will be climbing and possibly the 70s before the end of the week.
You know, as I look at this forecast, it's actually pretty decent. With the exception of tomorrow with a brief temperature dip, there are several chances of rain here, but I don't really believe in much of it. I mean, there's slight chances of rain. It'll bring in some spotty showers to the forecast. Today is one of the days where we see that slight chance of rain here, but it's quiet this morning. It's clear and it's dry as well. 47 degrees right now for Indianapolis. We'll continue to see conditions that are rather mild, 42 for Peru. So temperatures remain pretty chilly for you this morning. For some areas like Lafayette and Peru, most of us will see those mild conditions. All right, so let's do it. Let's go through TrueCast here and talk about that chance of rain. I think throughout most of the day, we're quiet. We're mostly sunny. It's not until the afternoon after your lunch hour we start to see this cloud cover start to thicken in the atmosphere. So there it is. Mainly, we're mostly sunny and then partly sunny. But then I think by later on this evening, we go mostly cloudy. All right, so here goes the chance of rain. You can see it's very slight. We're quiet. The spotty showers begin to move into the north there. As they slide in, I think Lafayette to Crawfordsville getting in on some spotty showers overnight. But overall, most of us just seen the thickening of the cloud cover in the atmosphere. So a few spotty showers there. So 8 a.m., mostly sunny, not as cool. Temperatures cloudy and mild throughout the afternoon, seeing a high temperature of 64 degrees. So 64 hitting the number at around 3 to 4 o'clock. And then overnight, I think temperatures are in the mid-40s. So Good looking forecast. Let's talk about Thursday. We're moving forward here. Thursday, another day where there's a slight chance of a spotty shower here in the forecast. It's not really impressive as we'll see the thickening of the cloud cover once again. Some spotty showers mainly on the western portion of the state, as you can see from Muncie into Richmond. But overall, we're remaining pretty dry, right? You see those showers starting to sneak in a little more for Greensburg into Richmond, even into parts of Seymour. Overall, I think we'll see a slight chance of rain on Thursday as well. Here's your Thursday forecast. The big issue on Thursday will be the cloud cover. That's going to inhibit our temperatures from warming, so only seeing a high of around 56 degrees. All right, so here's where it gets exciting. Friday, 68 degrees, mostly sunny, a few clouds thickening, a great day. My pick of the week on Friday, but Saturday's great too, so I had to pick Saturday as well at 72. Sunday, some spotty storms in the forecast with temperatures at 75 degrees. So there's your warming trend. We're still in the 70s next week, so something to look forward to. For today, Lauren, just pretty mild. Let's get a check of traffic now.
Hey, good morning, Ashley. Traffic moving along up to speed all over the metro area. Take a look here on the west side of town. This is I-465 at West 10th Street. You can see just a few headlights there on your screen. No delays to report on this side of town, but take a look at our traffic now map. Just a reminder about a few construction projects going on right now. Southbound I-65 near I-70, just past the Meridian Street exit at the north split. Road work in that area, as well as northbound I-65, the right lane blocked at Washington Street. The Washington Street exit still closed at this hour, so take it slow, avoid that area. And then eastbound I-70, as you get to Post Road, they are working in the right lane, so be careful in that area. Let's take a live look right now on the east side of town, I-70 at Shadeland Avenue. No delays to report there.
Only on RTV6 this morning, religion is a hot topic no matter where you go in the world, but it's now a changing part of life.
More and more faith groups are now getting outside of the walls of churches and synagogues and are spreading their message in unusual places.
It's a Friday night in Fishers. The drinks are flowing. There's a good crowd and some good news.
One third a party at a bar, one third a charity event, and one third a church service, I guess.
Pubmaster Darren Earlywine shares a Christian message when Pub Theology meets every month. He says this makes God and faith accessible.
But what we find is that people aren't tired of God. They're not tired of faith. They just want to know that he loves them and that they can access a relationship with him in real environments. And that's what we hope to provide.
Downtown, young people are setting, spiking, and praying.
We've seen faces that we haven't met before. Like we have about 415 people have come through our three seasons, and most of those people we've never met.
This season, the Archdiocese of Indianapolis is meeting new people, Catholic and otherwise, through volleyball.
And this is a beautiful example of people coming from different walks of life, different areas, and getting together and sharing a simple game of volleyball.
They've come to understand a simple game can build community and open a door to faith.
Especially in the modern world, maybe organized religion is becoming more obsolete, especially in our culture in America. We can take care of ourselves. We can control our own destiny and things like that.
Sunday Assembly, a group made up mostly of agnostics, focuses on community through its belief in humanism. It's a global movement that just launched in Indianapolis in January. Sunday Assembly get-togethers typically center around a service project. Whether it's in a bar, on a court, or doing good deeds, it seems many faith groups are leaning on community to appeal to millennials, because in the end, faith isn't about traditions. It's a matter of the heart.
So much we think about the infrastructure instead of the person of Jesus who's come to answer those longings in our heart.
Tonight at 11, I'll introduce you to a Noblesville man who has shared his message of salvation to millions. Why it's spreading like wildfire and why he says it's changing lives. Mark?
A house divided, Beth. Coming up on Good Morning Indiana, the family feud for the Tanner clan, the controversial tweet from a Full House star. That's coming up. Plus, the tipping point, the reason behind a man leaving a $3,000 tip on a $40 bill. Then special delivery, why a Metro police officer pulled double duty as a pizza delivery driver.